What does it mean to you to be not just here at the London Film Festival, but here at tonight's ceremony?
It's great. It's my first time actually to London, you know, and sort of getting this sort of treatment. It's nice that they treat documentaries sort of in the same realm, I think, as other films. You know, sometimes they're the sort of stepchild, I think, and here it's nice to have a proper presentation, you know, for a real, you know, form of cinema that deserves this kind of treatment, I think. So it's been fun.
As a documentary filmmaker, what do you think documentary gives both a filmmaker and an audience that they perhaps don't get from dramatization?
Yeah, I mean, it's this idea of kind of stranger than fiction, you know. Sometimes you can't write scenarios that happen, you know, in reality. It's like you couldn't make up some of the characters that are in this film, and I think that's what's kind of unique about it is it's hard to define people. People are inherently complex, and I think with documentaries you sort of like approach defining them, and it always reveals a lot more complexity, I think, in a character, in a subject, you know, than perhaps writing a character could do. So that's fun.
For people who weren't lucky enough to see your film at the festival, can you tell us a little bit about the characters you do focus on in that documentary and what attracted you to that story?
Yeah, it's a film about two Japanese artists that live in Dumbo, Brooklyn. The husband, Ushio, is quite famous in Japan for his action painting, and the wife has sort of always been his assistant and manager and cook and has never really gotten a chance in the spotlight like her more famous husband. So it's really, the film is about Noriko, the wife of this artist, sort of coming into her own as a creative painter and artist in her own right. And so the film, you know, is sort of, it's a love story essentially about how two creative and intensely competitive people can kind of come together and make something beautiful out of it.
Of course, I mean, I'd imagine the reaction has been different all around the world. Obviously, perhaps the Japanese audience sees their relationship and their bickering in a slightly different light as Western audiences, I would imagine.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, the Japanese audience, they got the film, they got the relationship immediately. You know, they didn't find, in the States, the reaction has actually been a little bit more somber and sad because they bicker a lot and they fight, but they're the kind of couple that sticks together through thick and thin. And some people ask, well, why, you know, why not just get a divorce or why not, you know, leave? And in Japan, it's much, you know, they understand why. It's sort of an, you know, you don't need to explain it.
Of course, I mean, you studied art yourself, but what have you learned from being immersed in these people's lives? Has given you a different perspective on what it means to be an artist and the lifestyle that comes with?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this was kind of an art school in a way, making this film. You know, I've known them for 5 years, so it's, the project essentially is, you know, over the course of 5 years. So I've, you know, it's always inspirational to be around artists. They were always making art, I was making art. They treated the film as sort of its own thing, you know, separate, its own piece of art in a way. So, which is nice. You can have, you know, more creativity. You can kind of do what you want to do and not worry so much about how the subject is reacting to their portrayal.